Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today I'm going to share with you how to trim your video clips in Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and check it out. Here I have a video project that I have already been working on. As you can see, I have all these video clips here. So what I did is shot these videos using my phone. This is a recap of an event that took place. You can see the final video on my Instagram channel if you want to check it out. That'll be the title there to search for it. Now, if you're interested in getting started with video, I have a video on that that you can check out. I'll have it in the description below. But this right here, I'm gonna share with you about trimming these. Now, some of these clips are actually longer than the time that you see here. For example, we got 3.7 seconds. I try to keep all of these around the same amount when I'm creating these recap videos. Now, some of these clips are actually longer than that. So I wanna show you how to trim those and give you some tips. First off, what you want to do is down here at the bottom, by default, the show layer timing is turned off by default. So what you want to do is turn that on, and that allows you to see the timing of the layer up here at the top. So you'll see that once you click on an actual clip, you'll be able to see, for example, let me go ahead and move it right about here. And if I click on the video clip up here, you'll see that there's some section that's bleeding out over here, and that's by design because this clip is actually longer than that. Now the next tip, and I'm gonna go ahead and close this right here, is over here in the bottom right corner, you're going to see a percentage here. Right now we're looking at it, the timeline at a 5% zoom. Now you can click here and show fit and choose all different percentages. What I like to do is just slide this so that I can see these video clips a lot more closely, and it makes my job easier to trim. So I'll do that here. Now what you'll want to do is use this slider right here, and that will take you through the entire timeline all the way to the end, which is right there. And you can see right there, I can add an additional scene. So I'm about almost 200% here. So what I'm going to do is, let's see, randomly pick a clip here. So let's see, let's try this one here. As you can see, some of the clip is actually out here in this area. It is grayed out, and whatever you see in the timeline is visible within these marks right here. So you got 2.7 seconds. So basically, here's what I'll do. Let me take this back to its original state. So what we're going to do, I'm going to slide that out all the way till we get to the entire clip. So this basically, I'm going in reverse of what I did. So here's the original clip. It's about 5.7 seconds, as you can see right here. We got 5.7 seconds. It's too much time. So when I create these recaps, I want them shorter. So here is the tip. First off, what you can do is, this right here is your video clip, your basic timeline video clip. What is visible? The top one is basically your clip. And this is basically what you see. This is what your audience will end up seeing. So what I will do is trim this down to about 3 point something seconds there, right about there. So 3.3 seconds is fine. Now, as you see, this part right here has been cropped out. This is not visible. This is what is not in view. So if I move my cursor, let me do something really quick here. A little caveat. Here, this is my music track right here. I'm going to mute it, that way you don't hear it while I demo this. Also, what I like to do here when I create my video clips is this actual clip right here, I've already muted. I've actually muted every single clip already. So I'm not using any audio from my video clips because this is a recap video. Okay, I got that out of the way. So now as I slide from here, so this is one scene right here. This is this original scene. So if I hit play, and then it jumps into the next scene, but I'm actually cutting out too much. And so let me come back here because as you can see my presenter right here, I want that clip to actually start further about right there. And so what I will do is click on this clip, and let's go ahead and move this slider. So as you can see, some of it is out of view. And so what I will do is slide this over so you can see what's showing up between this marker and this marker. So now I have some clip out here basically that's not going to be visible, and as well as over here. So now when I basically move the playhead, let's pretend that I hit play and then it jumps into this scene. There's a little lag right here as far as movement. So I'll want some of that movement. I'll slide it back this way. So now if I hit play and it goes into the next scene, oh, it's too much. So let me go right here and we're gonna actually move this way. We're gonna drag out this way. Basically, I'm trying to find the best section, which might be right here. So if I slide this, he's talking and then I've got it sliding out. Or if I want that point right there to be the start point, then I'm just gonna drag this over here. And so we'll hit play and it comes right there. And then it goes to the screen. I think that's what I had it do. Yeah, that's basically how I wanted this scene to look like. And so I might slide this just a tad bit. So basically I've trimmed this clip. I brought it down for 5 point something seconds, trimmed it down to about 3.3. And then after that, within the actual clip up here at the top, we can slide the actual video clip forwards or backwards, you know, move it between the timeline to show when I want that clip to start and when I want that clip to end. In essence, I'm trimming some of the fat of the video that I don't need to just have the juicy parts showing up. And that's how to trim your video clips in Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about the video, please drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. It helps YouTube share it with a wider audience. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, be good to one another and have fun creating. Peace.